The final welcome to it.
The final what?
The final of this tournament. Battlefield War tournament. Between the two masterminds, LegendofTotalWar and ThePrussianPrince.
It's an anticipated matchup.
Oh, it sure is. Everyone... People were expecting this one in the Attila tournament, but it never happened.
Yeah, the matchup that was avoided in the Attila tournament, thanks to LegendofTotalWar's sneaky tactics.
Of training someone.
Forcing someone else to beat ThePrussianPrince. But this time, he has to actually do it himself. We'll see if he puts the effort in.
Indeed. So for the first battle, we are on the regular map as usual. I told them they could use the maps in whatever order they wanted, but I guess they're still going for the normal map.
They just love this map. So fun and easy.
ThePrussianPrince playing as the Greenskins and LegendofTotalWar playing as the Vampire Counts. Let's have a quick look at the army. So we've got a line of Orc Biggins as the front line. We've got some Black Orcs as the second line. I believe that is Grimgore? Wait, no, this is an Orc Shaman. That's not. That's Azak the Slaughter. So there's a Shaman and Azak. That's interesting since, you know, they're both magic.
Double magic.
There's two Orc War Biggins, and the Giants.
Giant really far back, actually. So you're going to do like a dramatic run-in to join the battle later on. Should be good. Legends Army is quite an interesting one. We definitely haven't seen this composition before, so it's going to mix things up. He's got a left flank defended faithfully by two squads of Skeleton Spearmen. Then four units of Black Knights. Yep, all Black Knights, so a nice heavy left. Is it five? Five, I can count. And then a million units of Cairn Wraiths. So he's basically gone for the I don't want to lose any units approach to playing as the Vampires, where you bring the ones that are immune to damage.
Surprisingly, he brought them against the Greenskins, though, which, of course, Azak loves a bit of, what's the spell called again? The Fate of Bajuna against the unit that takes a lot of damage from magical damage.
Does he have enough? Because he's got to do that against like 8 units of Cairn Wraiths, and otherwise they're strong against the rest of the Orc army.
That's true, but even so, I don't know. We'll see.
We'll see. There's also a Necromancer hidden in there, and Heinrich Kemmler just in with the ghosts, just chilling.
I haven't seen Heinrich yet, I don't think.
Yeah, actually, it's probably the first time you've seen Heinrich being brought out.
It was a lovely little apron of human flesh.
It's very stylish. It's in this season. And on the right flank, we've got one unit of Flying Bats, and one unit, which we also haven't seen before, the Terrorgeist.
Have we not?
Which I think we haven't seen in this tournament so far.
I think
because it's really expensive or something. Maybe it just hasn't been seen as being worth it so far.
I think it's like 2,000 or something. Like it has to be super effective for it to be worth that amount of money. But maybe we'll find out how effective it really is.
Maybe he was thinking that the flying Azak might be brought, since it is ThePrussianPrince, and he wanted to bring him down with the Terrorgeist to stop any Spirit Liege madness from happening.
Oh yeah, maybe
it could have been a counter to that. But it looks like he's not going to need it, but maybe he'll use it anyway. Let's see them fight. In 3, 2, 1, fight!
Kill each other for amusement.
Do it. So far, nothing happening. They're just looking at each other. ThePrussianPrince going, God damn it, you brought only ghosts. Legend going, right. Where's the flying Azak? Oh, it's not there. Maybe I don't have to deal with that this time.
Well, my army composition won't work then.
I think I've got a good feeling about these ghosts. Ghosts against the Biggins and the Black Orcs. I feel like something good will happen.
You will find
possibly.
Out soon.
We've said before that so the Wraiths are always impossible to predict because their stats, the calculations are even more complicated than it is for two regular units fighting each other. So knowing the stats does not help you know what the outcome of the fight will be. Unless you have Wolfram Alpha at your side 24/7. Oh, narrow miss for the Terror guy. Someone's chucking some magic at it. He's going to get out of the way now.
I didn't even see that.
You missed it. It wasn't very good anyway. Looks like the orcs are going to use the hole to defend their flank there, but the big attack by the cavalry is probably going to come on the other flank, given Legend's positioning, so that may not actually be important. Bats just sitting there in front of the line. The orcs don't have anything to attack the bats with, so they can just hover threateningly above them. Oh, what's
this? There's another spell going off.
It's the Terror guy's getting spirit leeched. Oh, no. He's launching his shizzle at it. It's a hit.
Oh.
Did a little bit of damage. Maybe 10% of his health lost.
And it's like morale drops like
it was very scared by it, but the actual health damage quite okay. He'll be coming back from that, that's for sure. And I guess he's wasting magic. This is all magic that could have been used on those ghosts.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So it's good to just do this to force Prince to do something with his magic, because he can't otherwise attack the Terrorgeist until it strikes.
Is it going in for an attack, the Terrorgeist? No, he's
so close. I think he's just looming. He's just
I think the
being
wind
annoying.
from his wings might like knock over one or two big.
A bit of damage draft. Actually, it does have an attack order right now. It's attacking this unit of biggins on the other end of the line, so it's going to fly across the line and hit the other side. Hmm. Or is it? No, it's...
Oh, here it goes. Oh, no,
it was attacking the Shaman for a second there, but it turned off. It was just a feint. Orc's finally going to move forward. Legend is not really willing to move the rest of his army by the looks of things, so Prussian Prince going to have to just move up himself. Try and get over this phase of just being annoyed by the flying units.
Hmm.
Legend's going to be careful to try and get those skeleton spearmen to counter the Boar Boy Biggins.
No more magic being cast at the Terrorgeist.
Oh, here he goes. Ooh, oh, it's a hit. It's a hit. He's okay. Well, there's still plenty of health left. He's tanking this.
I don't know how much magic that costs to do that, but I don't know if it's worth it.
I mean, the Cairn Wraiths are still there. Black Orcs versus Cairn Wraiths is going to be the engagement I'll be very interested to see.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Looks like the cavalry's...
Meanwhile, a very unsubtle cavalry attack being set up here at the back. Has Prussian Prince noticed it? He might have.
I would say so. What is happening with the Cairn Wraiths, though? They're getting some kind of really weird...
He's going to blob up.
Blob them. He's blobbing them up.
What is this? They're all going to sit on top of each other.
Usually the blobs happens halfway throughout the match.
Yeah, normally the blob would be later.
He's just not waiting for it. He's just putting up the blob right away.
He wants that blob. Maybe they're stronger like this.
Oh,
exploited. Oh, my God. He just paid for that.
I'm glad I didn't miss that.
You messed up, Legend.
One of them coming down.
Wow, incredible.
Jesus. That was great.
That was good. A devolve would be so good right now. You could get all of them.
Wow, yeah.
You could just kill all those units with one hit.
Can Legend recover from that? That was rough.
That was a smash, yeah. Lost half the health on one unit and a bit of health on the others. Now the actual fighting begins, which
surprisingly, little damage if you, like, I mean, took a look at the actual
You'd hope
spell
it would do more.
Acid,
but it's a shame. Here goes the fight. All the orcs getting buffed up. Is that going to be enough to overcome the 80% damage resistance on the ghosts?
Oh, yeah, it was buffed, wasn't it? It was only... 75 before.
They're going to take like 2 damage per hit as opposed to like the 40 normally done by these units. So they can just sit there.
We should also mention that these battles were actually recorded after the patch 2 where the Beastmen were introduced. So they actually had the ability to play as the Beastmen as well. And all the stats obviously have been, or some of the stats have been changed on some of the units.
Yeah, the patch effects will have happened. Indeed. I'm sure both take that into account, being that they actually know what they're doing.
I think the major thing is that for the generals, you have to like click each like item and ability individually, essentially, if you want to use them, and it costs a lot more than they used to as well because of that. If you want to use everything they used to have, anyway.
Looks like the vampires might be in trouble here. Some of the Cairn Wraiths considering, not considering routing, they're disappearing, crumbling, and the cavalry attack still hasn't happened. He wants to avoid the Boar Boys, I guess, which isn't going to happen because they're hitting him right now.
Anzac's in there as well, and I think he's. Well, the Terrorgeist is attacking the Shaman, I think.
Yeah. Let's have a look. Yes, he is. Terrorgeist seems to have got some of its health back. Did Legend use his healing spell on it, or does it regenerate? I don't know.
It might have.
Didn't see the healing,
spell. I'm not sure. He doesn't look like he heals. Yeah, he does. Yeah, he heals by himself. If you look at his HP, he's constantly going
up. Going up. Good for him, then. He's having a great time, not being damaged by the units around him and smashing up that Orc Shaman.
Cavalry still just sitting back, the Black Knights.
He really wants to dodge the Boar Boys, which have a bonus against Cav, so just on principle wants them to do something first. And now they have done something. They've got into the melee, so maybe now will be the time to Cav strike. Look at that Orc Biggins unit with this rear just facing all those Cav units. It's so tempting. Go on. Have a cheeky rear charge.
It's being set up to receive the charge, I think.
Oh yeah, he's seen it. He's turned them round. It's too late. Do it anyway, though. It'll be fine. You're an anti-infantry unit. What the?
Yeah.
Another huge explosion. Devastating the ghosts.
More came down. I didn't even see it this time.
Ow. Yeah, the vampires. Actually, the vampires winning on the balance bar. I was going to say
they're
losing, but
I'm
not paying attention. But they always tend to be winning, even when they're losing, just to add to the confusion.
Yep. 100 Kemler in the middle of conflict as well as some Black Orcs. Oh, man. What the hell is happening over here? This Black Orc unit has died very quickly.
I think we're getting some buffs coming in to make these ghosts a little bit more effective, and she's starting to do some damage now. Not sure they can do much against the giant, which is going to be a problem for them. Gonna need to whip out some magic or something, or try and get the skeleton spearmen in against them.
Yeah, pulling those 2 spell skeleton spearmen.
Work.
Still no cavalry being used. I'm very surprised. You'd think this would be the ultimate time to do it.
I mean, I would say
but...
just cycle charge anyway.
Yeah.
Just do it into orc biggins. They're not that good. He'll kill some of them. Oh, he's going to split the cav up. This cav are actually... Ooh, they're going all the way to the other side of the map. They're going off on an adventure right now, and the Biggins are going to follow them.
Bat's still not being used either.
Bat's not up to much. I guess there's not much you can do with them right now. They're too weak to actually kill anything, so he just doesn't want to lose them. So they're just sitting
there. You're right about the camera is holding up pretty well, though. To be fair, they haven't done a whole lot yet, but they have been alive for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, their offensive stats are bad, but it's their defensive stats, which means they'll slowly kill things, and they can fight exhausted enemies and things like that to bring them down.
Yeah, that's true.
They've done some damage, but I say the balance bar's creeping into the vampire's favor a little bit more,
being
actually.
At the skeleton spearmen now.
Skeleton spearmen going into a fight. The cavalry finally making a move against the orc biggins now.
Ah.
Looks like they did a little bit of damage, killing some of them.
Indeed. Two of them being sent in, still three of them hovering
still
about.
Still waiting for a chance. He's right there. The orc biggins are forming up to receive the charge.
It looks like it's getting further and further in the vampire counts' favor, though.
It's strange. I feel like this is going well for the orcs. I'm not 100% sure where all the vampire's power is coming from. I guess because of all these undeployed cav units count for so much of the balance bar and they're not doing anything. That's why it looks like it's going so well for the orcs. And once he actually finally gets some utility from the cav, we might suddenly see a lot of orcs die.
Right, orcs, the first orc warrior vegan has been routed and the other one's actually pretty low as well.
Slow,
so
the cav's quite safe. It claims to be anti-infantry, this cavalry, but it doesn't have a bonus against
infantry.
Yeah, it
doesn't have a bonus.
So it's one of those lying things. It's just a normal unit. No particular strengths, but good enough against regular units. Well, the Skeleton Spearmen are failing in their attempts to bring down this Orc Biggins completely. He's almost lost a unit, and the other units lost. Oh, his morale's coming back up. I was going to say, it's about to lose all its morale, but it just bounced all the way back up to almost full.
There's two Spearmen that are fighting that one Orc Biggin unit. Those Orc Biggins have lost 8 so far.
8? It's all
and the Skeleton Spearmen are getting
got like
100 destroyed.
Kills. It's going well, but Legend is going to leave that fight going there. I guess he just wants the Biggins fighting.
Guess like he could use again the cavalry. He could just charge in there.
He could save the Skeleton Spearmen if he wanted.
He's doing it now. Okay.
No, he's actually going to go past them. He's going to go into the main melee with those guys.
He knocked one of them over.
He touched one. They're a little bit freaked out by that, at the very least. What's this?
They harassed him.
Heinrich had run off chasing some rousing units, but he's now going to start coming back towards the fight. He's off in the corner. Try and get involved again. Vampire's gaining more of an advantage now.
Yeah,
these cavalry rear attacks that finally happened.
Most of the cavalry is still just sitting there, with fairly decent HP as well.
Yeah, there's a couple of ones that haven't really fought very much.
Just the giant just doesn't do a whole lot either against them.
It's too slow. You'd think that with the giant, it's got, 500 attacks. So even when you lose 80% of your attack, if you're doing 100 hit point damage to a unit, that should still kill every unit you hit? I don't know.
Well,
yeah,
the thing is,
I think they have
about
50 HP a Cairnwraith individually.
I think what I see with the Cairnwraith as well is that they don't really get knocked down, so even when the giant attacks them and they don't die in one hit, they just get sort of like brushed to the side, but they still keep on fighting.
They might have an animation advantage. Short animations means you do more stuff. Sneaky advantage for the Cairnwraiths. Oh, the bats have finally gone into action. They're just attacking some rousing units now. Prince has some Boar Boy Biggins out there in the corner.
I guess that's maybe why he used or why he brought the fell bats just to bring down those weak units.
Yeah,
there's
gonna
some
work well now. So the official blob has now started. Pretty much everything's in the blob. It's just a big fight.
Blobbing up.
Legend just has to find a way to bring down the giant. I'm guessing his cav might eventually do it.
They're probably around before the battle is over.
Cav are in trouble. There's two of them there. He's about to lose two units of the cavalry. Three more still fighting away. Oh, he's finally gone to save the Skeleton Spearmen.
Oh, yes.
Of them might get away with this now, if the calf can get enough attention from the Biggins. I think they might just about pull this off, because the Orcs are going to rout very soon. Poor Skeletons are going to get out of this one alive.
I think this is, that's
heroic Skeletons.
90 men left still. They actually now have an advantage over the Orc Biggins.
Yes, finish them. But get your revenge. They are totally crumbling, but crumbling too
they
slow.
They lost their full units, plus another 80 in this one as well. So that's, I think Orc Biggins are definitely a little better than Skeleton Spearmen.
We've confirmed that Orc Biggins beat Skeleton Spearmen.
I think we're about to see the victory for the Vampire Counts here.
The Terrorgeist is still going strong. For some reason, I had this thing in my head that Terrorgeist would just die instantly. But I know it seems to be doing quite well. I don't know if it's paid for itself. It would have been better to bring 3 Graveguard Great Weapons or something instead of that. But who knows? Oh, and there it is. It's a close victory. Very nice.
I don't know
indeed.
About that. There's a pretty big vampire blob still there, but sure game.
There's a big blob. I guess a lot of the cav died. A lot of the ghosts probably died. I think there were just so many to start with, even though it looks like there's loads. He actually lost like 70% of the ghosts, but who knows. There you have it. The all-ghost army. pretty effective there. Wasn't much, except for that giant use of the Foot of Gork, which was,
that was pretty
super
crazy, yeah.
effective. That was the best
Two
thing he could
do. And it still didn't actually really
It's not
matter.
Good enough. They're weak against magic, but they're not very weak against magic, and they are very strong against everything else in the game. So, yeah. Pretty decent unit to spam. Seems
yeah,
to
I mean,
well.
If you look at it that way, they seem really overpowered, because the thing that counters them was used against them, and they still didn't care enough. It's still, like, it wasn't even close. Like,
that's true. I think their real counter is some of the shamans, I think some of the Bright Wizard, maybe, on the Empire, has an ability that turns all of your attacks into magical attacks for the whole army for a short period of time. So it looks like a buff, basically. So you'll buff some of your units to make them magical, and then they fight the Kenwraiths and defeat them easily, because Kenwraiths have, like, half the amount of health of an average unit.
Yeah.
So that's, I think, the super hard counter, but you can only do that if you happen to have all the stuff you need to do that, so it's just luck whether you can counter it or not. And unfortunately, Prussian Prince didn't have the appropriate gear.
Indeed.
So, well, GG. But it's best of five, so they have to fight again.
See some more battles. All right, the second battle. It is once again the Vampire Counts, this time on the Prussian Prince's side, against the Dwarves on Legend of War, Total War side.
Legend of War, totally side. Legend of Age of Empires 2 is back for another battle. And it's Boxo Clock. Absolutely no mercy with this box formation. It's
full-on dwarfed
Huge
it up.
Huge rectangle.
Like, if this happened in Attila, we'd be like, I don't know if we can allow this. But, you know, in Warhammer, the dwarfs, this is kind of
no shield wall or anything, so it's not even that powerful. Like,
that's true.
The charge will still go through you, so it's less exploity.
The dwarves are, this is what they're meant for, I feel like. They have to box it up a little bit. They have no mobility, so there's not
yeah,
really much.
This is the best formation for the dwarves. It just looks a bit strange.
I can't blame them. Anyway, let's have a look at the formation. So once again, I think Prussian Prince has taken one under the book out of the Legend of Total War.
He's brought basically the army that Legend just brought.
I think there's nine turns this time instead of eight. Or ten even. Yeah, it might be ten. I can't even, it's nine, I think. Yeah, whatever. It's 9 or 10. It's a million or so. And he's got some Skeleton Warriors as well in the mix there. I think he's got 3 Skeleton Warriors I saw, and then 1 Skeleton Spearman somewhere.
Yeah, I saw a Spearman on the load screen. I think he's on the far right, yeah. He's on Prussian Prince's far right of the ghost line.
He's got 2 units of Felbats, 2 units of Blood Knights, which is cool, and we've seen that, those too much yet. Actually, he's got another unit of Felbat there, and another one there. He's got 3 Felbats, not 1. And he also has Mr. Heinrich Kimmler, which I think, because of the way the generals were changed now, people are like forced to go with like lesser generals because they're so expensive now. And I think that's also the reason why Azak wasn't on his flying mount last time, is because they increased the prices for the mounts, I believe, by like 100 or a few hundred or something. So it's just not really viable doing it anymore because it's so expensive.
It's a shame. No more Manfred. It was always Manfred. Now it's always Heinrich.
Exactly.
That's never... rioting.
Yeah.
So let's have a look at what Legend's done.
Yes.
You can pretty much tell what's happening here. It's long beards. The problem is it's going to be odd units, so there's going to be no way to mentally map what this formation's up to. But let's look at it anyway, as if we can. Lots of starting from the right, on the front of the box, we've got long beards, great weapons, then hammerers to their left. Then hammerers, and long beards, great weapons. Okay, we've got a symmetrical front line. This is good. The curve on both sides, is it Dwarf Warriors? No, it's Dwarf Warriors defending the left flank, and Longbeards defending the right flank, and on the back, it's Longbeards, Dwarf Warriors, Longbeards, Longbeards, Dwarf Warriors. It could be better in terms of organizational symmetry levels. I feel like there's going to be a weak point in this box.
I think maybe he's done this to confuse Prussian Prince as well.
It's confusing everyone, which might now, work to his benefit, because he doesn't have to do as much micro in this fight, so that's good. And he's got a whole bunch of Quarrelers just sitting in the middle ready to fire out, along with a Grudge Thrower, which currently looks like it's exploding, but hopefully that is a beneficial explosion.
Yeah,
it all looks good. A Runesmith and the Chairman at the front also exploding themselves, and the Grudge Thrower already firing, apparently, so I'm going to have some action right from the start. Not going to do too much against the Ghosts, but with its high damage, might be able to take some of them out.
Is it firing at those bats? Like, what else could be firing?
As you might.
The angle.
Just about being in range. Actually, it's in range of quite a lot of stuff. It's in range of most of the ghosts. Big range.
Oh, okay. So, oh yeah, right.
Nice deployment spots. So let's watch them fight in 3-2-1 fight. Let's see what
short
happens.
Short of battle this time around. Oh, here comes the charge immediately.
Fight. He's turning the Grudge Throwers. They are targeting the bats, but now they're re-shifting, targeting the Blood Knights, I think, by the looks of it. And the bats up to no good straight away. They're off on a mission.
Are they starting to make trouble in your neighborhood?
They need to not get near the formation, because they're going to get quarreled with if they do. So that's going to be a big... source of angst for the bats. What can he do with them? He can try and engage the quarrelers, I guess, in melee, but I think they would also lose that. Now the crawler's actually doing what I just said. And they're going to get out of the way. Doesn't actually want his bats to die. Controversial.
Yeah, those bats are going to get absolutely destroyed by crawlers, I imagine. Even in melee, they can't
yeah,
do
I
that
think
well.
They can keep them occupied like you can with the orc goblin archers or something.
Yeah, I think the bats are going to be a poor choice for this one. Not that he could have known. Well, I guess if you're playing against dwarves, you probably could have known.
It's always a guess. Like, literally 50% of your ability to win a battle is based on your guess for the army composition. Yeah, so there is a random element in every fight. But anyway, the ghost's coming in. I guess all he can do here is pick a point on the box to attack and do it. A rain of arrows coming down upon those ghosts. Actually,
definitely looks like it'd be better
damage
to attack from the side or the back, but the thing is, that means you'd have to run around, which means that
Legend
would take damage
turn
from the quarters
things and constantly down. Shoot them. They're focus firing one unit of ghosts, and actually, look at it, it's losing a lot of health.
Yeah,
I think it's just so many arrows that they're overcoming the damage resistance. Not bad at all, but now the rest are going to make it to melee successfully. And the bat's coming in now. Might be able to rear attack.
Oh man, that unit's oh, it just got ruined, wrath of ruined, and it's dead.
Goodbye.
See you later, Karen.
See ya. They're also being healed at the same time. Heinrich's using the healing spell, but can he keep them alive? They're basically dead.
It looks like, the effect ended the rune, wrath of ruin, so now it's just
health going back up. Bats making attacks all over the place. I guess just keeping those archers busy.
Crazy amounts of buffs going off everywhere as well.
Oh my god, buff micro is real.
Jesus.
So
everyone's
crazy.
Everyone's got some white glow around them. Units from white. Blood.
There's a lot of stuff going on. Suffice to say, a lot of these guys just exploding all over the place.
Blood Knights around, coming around the back now.
Blood Knights might get a chance to smash through at some point.
They're slightly charging uphill as well, which is also unfortunate for the vampire counts here. On the backside, it's all... I guess that's probably a good thing by Legend. I wonder if he did that on purpose. I assume he did. He just put them slightly on a downhill slope so that he's
gone. Yeah, the best spot he had available on an otherwise quite plain map.
Yeah.
Oh, here comes another attack on the Cairn Wraiths. Where is it? It says they're being healed. I thought I just saw some hostile magic going off on them, but I might be lying.
There's a lot of invocation and the hecking going on here.
So much invoking.
The Blood Knights charging through. The Longbeards got stuck right there. I think the latest patch, they changed the charge resistance a lot.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. So it actually resists charges as advertised.
All the units don't get completely thrown around the map
so
anymore
they
from the charge.
Get inside the box because of that. They can do some damage with a cycle charge. You just micro that.
Yeah, they're definitely doing a little bit of that. I'm surprised how much. I think that's also a thing now. It's because they resist the charge more. They also take more damage because they actually take the damage.
Yeah, they might be subject to more attack animations and actually lose more health from the charges as a result because they spend less time lying on the floor.
Because it seemed like cavalry was really in a weird way before this patch, essentially. Like, they were really strong because they could push through units that easily, but they were weak because they couldn't really...
it didn't do much damage. It just looked like it did.
Yeah. Henry Cameron have taken a bit of a beating as well already now.
The arrow's still raining on those ghosts.
Using the overcharged invocation hack, which is really good because it actually it makes it an AoE heal, which is really a big...
That's what I saw earlier. That's when I thought, oh, that's done magic. No, he's just healing all the ghosts at once, so that's quite nice.
Yeah, you can heal, like, it's a really big AoE, so you can heal a lot of units.
Just to the side of that, it looks like this Longbeard's great weapons may lose to the ghosts who are sort of pushing in there, so he might get a breakthrough into the box in a second.
Yeah.
Blood Knight's just cycle charging, taking damage though with every cycle charge.
The Canaries have armor piercing, so they're actually a good choice against the dwarves as well.
Ah, that's true. I didn't realize they had armor piercing. They're even better than I thought they were. Bad news for the dwarves. Look, is this going to be another mass heal for all of the wraiths? I think it is.
Blood Knights have pushed through into the corridors now and taken them down pretty rapidly here.
Oh, they're in. So
Blood Knights are a lot stronger now because of the buff, essentially, because I thought they were quite weak before, but they seem to be doing a lot of damage now.
I was going to try and help the wraiths get through those Longbeards.
Our Blood Knight pulling through all the way into the corridors now. Just it's ramming through the... There's a hammer unit in the way, but he doesn't care. Just ramming.
push in. Stop the archers firing. Save the ghosts.
It's chaos now. No blobbing yet, luckily, because it's such an odd formation. There's still several units at the back for
he's got units
Legend
to deploy. He's still worried about that rear attack. I think he could get away with actually pulling them in to kill the Blood Knights. Oh, he might be doing that now, actually.
Yep.
As his front line breaks at the same time, so he's basically just going to replace that front line with another one.
This is a close one, huh? It's only a minute left.
A lot of stuff's going to die very quickly, basically.
I mean, the dwarf warriors have high morale, so I can't see them all dropping in the next minute, but the Karen Race are all still really high as well, so I don't know.
Well, the Blood Knights basically expended now. They're all dead. Some of the Karen Race units going down, but the ones all around Heimrich have been kept alive. I guess they don't really have a way to kill all these units in this amount of time, though, because their attack's too low. So
yeah,
maybe
that's
going to crumble
thinking.
In a second.
Yeah, but why? Unless Heimrich dies, that could be it.
Oh, yeah, yes, he is under attack. I think, is he being killed by the Shareman? The Grudge Bearer is going to bear his grudge all over Heinrich. That might finish him off. Yeah, that could certainly explain the battle length. And the Dwarves actually gaining advantage on the balance bar as well.
Oh, yeah.
They might just winning anyway. They might just beat the ghosts in a straight melee.
Oh, there goes.
The Lord's Heinrich. Down. What effect is that going to have? I'm going to start seeing some more crumbling. Not that crumbling is hugely important. Just got to push them over the edge.
Disintegrating now.
Diminishing. Is it diminishing? No, disintegrating, that's it. Diminishing is the one that's even less important.
Such an importance. There you go.
There they go. They disappeared.
Oh, victory. Oh my god. Oof.
A huge, colourful ghost explosion.
It's beautiful.
To celebrate the end of that fight. Very colourful. Quite like that. So that's a close victory for Legend.
So again, so that's 2-0 for
the
Legend now.
Strategy working well. And Prussian Prince must be frustrated with that because he saw the power of Kenwraith and he was like, I'll do that. And it just didn't work. Like, he did exactly what he should have done. Attacked units that are weak against Kenwraiths with Kenwraiths. But it did not work. Because that's the end of that sentence. Right. Time for the next battle.
You're right, because like, he's probably annoyed in the previous battle. His foot of Gork did it didn't do enough against the Kenwraiths. So you'd think, okay, well, I bring them as well then.
That's it. He saw our Legends bringing Dwarves. Right? They got no magic. I'll bring this thing. They'll only be killed by magic. Maybe we'll win. No, turns out they're weak against Quarrelers for some reason. So that's the end of that. Too bad.
Well, let's find out what they do in the fur battle. There's not going to be any Karen Wraiths, that's for sure.
Well, there better be. Both bring vampires, both all Karen Wraiths. That's my prediction for the next fight.
It is the third battle in the best of five between the Legend and the Prussian.
And has the Prussian Prince thrown it? Because what he did is he clicked on Chaos in the battle setup menu.
That must have been an accident.
He must have been a mixed click, and then he just like accidentally started clicking on all the units with his eyes closed.
I think they actually got buffed like crazy in the last patch as well. So yeah, I imagine they would be all right. Except it looks like Legends of the War was once again ahead of him and brought exactly the counter to an army like this. But we'll get to that in a second. So first of all, I guess we'll have a look at this army of the Prussian Prince. So he's brought a small line of Chaos Warriors here in the center. He's got some Chaos Warriors of Halberds on the flanks, four of them total. He's got three Chaos Knights with Lances. He's got one Dragon Ogre unit. And he's got Kolak Sun Eater as his general as well. And that's it.
Nice stuff. Some of those units are going to be useful. But he needs to be able to use them, which I think is going to be a problem for him.
Yeah, I mean, if he's got a lot of halberds, well, four of them, which is a decent amount, and then if you compare that to Legend's army, he's got cavalry only,
the Dragon Ogres and Shagoth, what's his face, Kolek, are both anti-cavalry as well, in theory. But yes, as we can see, Legend has gone for the all-fast, all-mounted army. At the back, five units of Demogryph Knights Halberds. We've said a couple of times before in the tournament that if you want to win, you just keep clicking on the Demogryph Knights with Halberds button, and a few people did it once or twice. Legends decided he wants to win. He clicked on it a large number of times. That's how you do it.
He probably didn't click enough, to be honest.
He could have clicked more. He spent a lot of money on Outriders there, but anyway. He's also got Karl Franz flying, and is an Amber Wizard flying? Yes, it is. Is he going to use Devolve?
I haven't seen him yet.
He better.
I don't know. We haven't seen the Amber Wizard yet.
Yeah, first time seeing Ambers, yeah. And he's also got these six units of Outriders. Vanguard deployed to just shoot Chaos from the beginning, and of course, against Chaos, he doesn't have to worry about anything being fired back at him, because Chaos do not have the luxury of being able to do anything against ranged units. So, they're just going to get shot.
3 minute and 40 second battle.
Super fast battle, let's get into it. 3, 2, 1, go. You can predict the start is going to be everything getting shot. Instant
volley. Well, the units is getting knocked back immediately by the guns.
Fall over. So I'm guessing it's going to want to use Outriders to kill all the Halberdiers so that his Demogryph Halberds can just kill everything else.
Outriders can only fire forwards, so they actually need
to stop. It's possible those Chaos Knights can catch up with them. Let's check the speed stats. It's 66 versus 80, so the Outriders can get away, but he won't be able to fire, that's for sure. Is he going to move the rest of his army up? He's not. He's probably going to try and draw the Chaos all the way back towards the Demogryphs before he uses the Demogryphs.
I'd imagine so, yeah.
Oh, he might
especially
get caught.
Run!
It says they're faster by quite a significant margin, but they are not. We can confirm that. They're actually not.
They're getting caught one by one. I think that's because they're in the charge animation, the Chaos Knights of Lances, because they're so close.
Ah, so it gives them a speed boost. Well, that is sneaky. Yeah. The Outriders can't do anything about that. And the Demogryph's going to run backwards.
Oh my god, one of them already gone. Ooh, this could be pretty bad here.
Oh yeah, destroyed
Chaos
instantly.
Not turning around because the Demogryph Knights are...
No, Demogryphs, yeah. Demogryphs, not really anything Chaos can do against the Demogryphs. Try and get the Halberd infantry to fight them.
The Outriders somehow regained their morale while being... like being.
Wow, how did they get away with that?
I have no idea. Where is that unit, though? Like, there's only one guy,
right? I think
it's
just the guy with the flag.
Oh, yeah,
the rest of it actually made it out. The flag bearer's dead, but they always hated him, so the morale's gone up.
Now it's charging into Kolak. They're going to take Kolak down so fast.
They can win that.
You've seen that before happening.
They can win that, and all the Chaos Knights lances coming in, and despite them having lances, they are not good against cavalry, just to confuse old Total War players.
Are they going to do anything cool with his Ajik?
Could be time for some Amber Wizard magic.
Oh, there you go. That's a Devolve coming down right there. Flock of Doom. Flock of Doom's alright as well, actually.
Flock of Doom. I've heard some good things about Flock of Doom. On the grapevine. Oh, look at this blob. Absolutely no pretense of strategy in this battle. Everything just going to run in.
Kolak down to half HP and still dropping relatively fast.
Yeah, he will absolutely lose.
Damage now, but if Kolak dies, then that's probably going to be it. I mean, we've only got a minute and a half left now, so...
All that gunfire just going to be slowly damaging Chaos. He's got terrible line of sight. He really should move the gun somewhere else, but...
I think he's also trying to fire
Now as they switch target, yeah. They can do amazingly against those halberdiers.
Kolak is... Deadsies.
Out. Balanced by advantage pops up for Empire. Chaos units routing all over the place.
Oh my god, how are they already routing? Some of them barely lost anything.
Like, annihilated. The lances finally got rid of those outriders on one side. The rest continuing to shoot into the flank of the halberdiers. It's bad day. It's bad day. More Flock of Doom.
Chaos fire today.
Ouch, ouch, ouch. Even at this stage, the halberdiers... Sorry, the Chaos... Demogryph Knight's halberds can kill the Chaos Warriors, brackets halberds.
Yes.
So, Empire wins.
I hear another
I'm calling shot. It.
Oh, what? Nah, there's no way. I think Chaos has got this.
Chaos wins, I'm calling it.
I think you were right. Professor Prince threw this one by clicking the Chaos button.
He shouldn't have clicked on Chaos. He just shouldn't have done it. What he should have done is click Vampires and brought loads of Cairn Wraiths. That would have been okay. Oh yeah. We should have done it again.
We should have broken the
rules.
We should
have just done it. That would have been fine against this army. There's loads of Cairn Wraiths. The bullets would just go right through them. Halberds go right through them. They'll be fine. But alas, in go the Dragon Ogres. Strong against the Halberds, but there's so many of them. It's not going to make a difference. Yes, and they're strong against them. Counter each other. So instant death for everyone. Bish bash bosh. Decisive victory. One of the rare decisive victories in the tournament.
Indeed, and that is a decisive victory for Legend of Total War.
That's it. That's the game point. He wins the entire tournament with that gloriously not fair final battle. Doing things that in many tournaments would be absolutely against the rules, and he's pulled out a victory using that tactic.
If we host another Warhammer tournament, we are definitely doing some kind of thing with banning or at least reducing.
I think two or four is the limit for Demogryphs in competitive, like, ranked matches.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
I think we'd do two if we did it, because I think four is still a huge
amount. Four is still very good. You only had five this time, and that, like, took the entire army in melee on its own, so you don't need anything else, really.
Yep. Alright, so that is the tournament. Congratulations to Legend of Total War, and, of course, to Prussian Prince and Total War Zone as well for getting third.
Second or third,
there's going to be the award ceremony as well, hopefully soon. We'll be able to record that too, and we'll probably have Legend guesting once again.
Yes,
like
we'll ask him what he thinks. Does he feel guilty? Is he going to learn sportsmanship?
Did he burn everyone's village down again?
Who's dead? Who's still alive?
This time we're actually going to have some prizes as well.
I forgot about that.
Prizes to give away to their subscribers on their own channels and such. But we'll obviously get to that in the award ceremony. Keep an eye out for that. I hope you guys enjoyed the actual tournament. I did anyway. I don't know about Devin, but...
You know. Well, I did enjoy it, but, you know, passed a bit of time. Saw some pretty good tactics, or some pretty bad tactics.
Some pretty big cheesing.
And saw, some exploits. So, one day, if they balance the game a little bit, this will be the most competitive game of all time. Right now, you can click a win button if you want. unfortunately.
Or a lose button.
Or there are win buttons and lose buttons on the interface. They need to patch that out and make those buttons be at least very hidden so people can't find them.
Like, I want to play as Chaos. No, no.
It just pops up. Are you sure you want to play as Chaos? Then it shows their like win-loss ratio.
You really want to lose this next battle. All right, anyway, thank you guys all for watching. We hope you enjoyed. We will see you for the award ceremony soon.
See you later.